देवते वसुदेवाया सरस्वतीं व्यासं
देवीं सरस्वती व्यासं
ततो जयमुदीरयेत्
ततो जयमुदीरयेत्
नष्टप्रायेषु पापत्रेषु
नष्टप्रायेषु पापत्रेषु
नित्यं भगवत सेवया
नित्यं भगवत सेवया
भगवते उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नष्टि We're going through the prayers by Queen Kunti and we're on the first canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, chapter 8. That this evening we're going to read text number 28.
我们要继续来讲述昆体皇后的祈祷，这是在圣殿博伽瓦坛第一篇第八章的第28诗节。
Manye Tvam Kalam Ishanam Manye Tvam Kalam Ishanam
Manye Tvam Kalam Ishanam
Anadi Nidanam Vibhum
Anadi Nidanam Vibhum
Samam Charantam Sarvatra
Samam Charantam Sarvatra
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Jodalama?
No.
Joshan? Joshan?
It's
Manye Tvam Kalam Ishanam
Manye Tvam Kalam Ishanam
Anadi Nidanam Vibhum
Anadi Nidanam Vibhum
Samam Charantam Sarvatra
Samam Charantam Sarvatra
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Tvam Kalam Ishanam
Manye Tvam Kalam Ishanam
Anadi Nidanam Vibhum
Anadi Nidanam Vibhum
Samam Charantam Sarvatra
Samam Charantam Sarvatra
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Monday
Tam Kalam Ishanam
Manye Tam Kalam Ishanam
Anadi Nidanam Vipum
Anadi Nidanam Vipum
Sarvam Charantam Sarvatra
Bhutanam
Yamitakali
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Chant.
Manyetram Kalamishanam
Manyetvamishanam
Anadi Nitalam Vipum
Anadi Nitalam Vipum
Samancharatam Savatra
Samancharatam Savatra
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Manyetam kalam isanam
Manyetam kalam isanam
Anadi nitalam vipun
Anadi nitalam vipun
Samancharatam sarvatra
Samancharatam sarvatra
Bhutanam Yamitakalihi
Bhutanam Yamitakalihi
Shomaniji
Manye Tvam Kalam Ishanam
Manye Tvam Kalam Ishanam
Anandi Nidanam Vipum
Anandi Nidanam Vipun
Samancharatam Sarvatra
Samancharatam Sarvatra
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Manyetvam kalam ishanam
Manyetvam kalam ishanam
Ananti nidanam vipun
Ananti nidanam vipun
Samancharatam savatra
Samancharatam savatra
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Manyetam Kalamishanam
Manyetam Kalamishanam
Anandi Nidanam Vipum
Anandi Nidanam
Samancharam Tashavacha
Samancharam Tashavacha
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Manyetakalanishanam
Anandi Nitanam Vipun
Anandi Nitanam Vipun
Savacharata Savatra
Samancharatam Savatra
Bhutanam Yamitakali
Bhutanam Yamitakali
译文：我的主，我认为您是永恒的时间，至尊控制者，您永恒存在，没有开始和结束，您无所不在，您对众生一视同仁，平等施予仁慈。生物体之间的不和，起源于它们相互间的交际往来。
Om Gyanatim Rundasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chasumi Avnena Tadasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sabhitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Tadam Ayam Dadati SwapadantikamBandeham Shri Guru Shri Yata Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavam Sya Shri Rupam Satrajatam Sahagana Jagannatham Vitam Tam Satyavam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya DevamShri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakha Nishamascha He Krishna Karna Sindhu Dhina Pandu Chagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namaste Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavanishwari Vrishamanusate Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Karpata Rupyascha Kriva Sindhu Balayacha Paritanam Bhavanebhyo VaishnaveyoShrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Saraswati Devi Kaurani Racharine Nirvishesha Shunyavani Paschajate Sarvarine Jai Shri Krishna ChaitanyaPrabhu Nityananda Shri Adita Gadara Shri Vasadi Goramata Vinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare So we're hearing the prayers of Queen Kunti as Lord Krishna prepares to depart to Dwarka.
那正当Krishna 准备好要启程到 Dwarka 去的时候，那么昆蒂王后献上了这些祈祷文。
Kunti is appreciating the very exalted position of Lord Krishna.
Krishna, 他欣赏着 Krishna 崇高的地位。
Now Krishna, it appears that Krishna is the relative of Kunti. She is his aunt because Lord Krishna appeared as the son of Vasudeva and Devaki. And Vasudeva was the brother of Kunti.
那在此呢我们知道事实上昆蒂王后跟 Krishna 他们有着这种亲戚的关系因为Krishna 显现为 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 的孩子而昆蒂王后是这个 Vasudeva 的妹妹所以等于是他们有这样的这种亲戚的关系 是姑姑，她是 Krishna 的姑姑。
But Kunti is aware of Lord Krishna's divinity, that he's not an ordinary person.
但是昆蒂王后她非常的清楚 Krishna 的这种神性的这种地位。他知道 Krishna 不是一个普通人。
And she's describing some of the very unique qualities of Lord Krishna.
所以在此昆蒂王后她在描述着Krishna 的一些非凡的品质。
She begins by saying, I consider your lordship to be eternal time.
那么她一开始她就先说，我认为我的主，我认为您是永恒的时间。
Now, of course, in the Bhagavad Gita, we know Lord Krishna had shown the Vishwarup form to Arjuna.
我们都知道在博迦梵歌中我们读到Krishna 向 Arjuna 展现了他的宇宙形象。
And Lord Krishna had also shown the form of Kalarup, the form of time, where the different kings were all entering into the mouths, they were all being killed in the battle of Kurukshetra.
而且 Krishna 也向 Arjuna 展现了他的 color rule， 也就是说看到所有在场的人，那些士兵们、战将们，他们都纷纷冲向 Krishna 的大嘴，吞没永恒时间，吞没了一切。
And Arjuna saw how all the great warriors who were coming to the battle of Kurukshetra, how they were all entering into the mouths and they were being devoured in the form, in the universal form.
所以 Arjuna 他亲眼看到那些战场上的那些战将士兵们，他们就冲向 Krishna 的那种燃烧的大嘴，那他的那种烈火魂焚烧了所有的人，所有的一切，就是这个宇宙形象它等于吞没了所有的一切。
Lord Krishna, Arjuna asked Lord Krishna, Who are you?
所以 Arjuna 他非常的震惊，他说你是谁？
And Lord Krishna replied in the famous verse, he said, Time I am, the destroyer of the world.And I come to claim all people.
他那有很有名的一节诗 ，Krishna 就说：“我是时间，我到此，是为了毁灭所有的一切。”
So Srila Prabhupada explains to us that this kala, meaning eternal time, that this is a feature of the Paramatma. Paramatma is, of course, the Lord in the heart of every living entity. And Kala is a feature of the Paramatma.
Kala, 永恒时间，其实就是 Paramatma, 超灵的一个特质。因为超灵处在每个生物体的时间，它见心中他见证的所有的一切，其实他就是永恒时间。
So, the Paramatma is a witness to all of our activities.
所以超灵他见证着我们每一个生命的所从事的所有的活动。
And eternal time also is a witness.To everything we have done.
而永恒时间 Kala 它也是那个见证者，它见证着我们每一个人所从事的所有的一切活动。
We forget what we have done. We don't remember all the things we have done.
我们可能会忘记，我们常常忘记我们曾经做过的事情。
If we were to ask you, you know, what were you doing this time last night?May be difficult for you to remember.
如果现在问大家，你昨天晚上做了些什么？可能大家会觉得，有点记不得了。我昨天晚上干了什么
？So, super soul, the Lord in the heart, He remembers every one of our activities.
可是超灵啊，它位居在我们心中的超灵，它见证着，它记忆着我们所从事的一切活动。
So he reminds us about everything which happened.
所以超灵它会提醒我们啊，我们曾经做过些什么。
And in this way, the super soul is directing us in different ways to perform activities.
所以超灵啊，它既然见证着，因此它会给我们一些指示，它会指挥着我们来从事各种不同的活动。
People think, you know, some people think I'm free. I can do what I like.
有些人会觉得我是自由的，我可以随心所欲做我想做的事情。
Some people even say, "You Hare Krishna people, you know, you're not free. You have rules to follow. But I'm free. I can do what I like. I can smoke. I can drink. I can eat what I like."
有些人就说：“你们这些 Hare Krishna 的人啊。”你们真的可怜，你们都要遵守，你们都不自由，你们要遵守那么多的规范原则，哈，这个不能做啊，要做这个，这个不能做这个。但是我们很自由，我们想做什么就可以做什么，我们想抽烟，我们想喝酒，多畅快呀，我们随心所欲。
So of course they're thinking they're free.
所以人们会以为自己是很自由的。
But actually they're controlled.By the material energy.
但是事实不然，其实啊，那些人他们是被物质的能量牢牢地控制着，而不自知。
We are also controlled by the spiritual energy.
而我们呢，啊，是被灵性的能量所控制着。
We have the shelter of the spiritual energy, and the materialistic people.They're under the material energy.
我们奉献者托庇的是所谓的灵性的能量，而一般的人，他们是在物质的能量的控制下。
Everyone is controlled.
每一个人都是受到控制的。
We are serving Krishna, and they are serving Maya.
我们在服务 Krishna, 可是一般人他们在服务 Maya 幻觉能量。
Yeah, Maya means幻觉 the illusion.
对 ，Maya 意味着幻觉。
So the devotees are fortunate that they can take shelter of Lord Krishna.
奉献者能够托庇于 Krishna， 真是太幸运了。
Lord Krishna is described by Queen Kunti as being without beginning and without end.This is a description of God.
在这节诗中，昆蒂王后还描述至尊主是没有开始和结束的。这样的描述其实指的就是神。
Of course, we could say, well, we are also without beginning and without end. We are all souls. And the soul, the nature of the soul, is without beginning and without end.
那我们也会说，因为我们是灵性的灵魂，所以我们也无始无终啊，我们也是没有开始、没有结束的。
If people ask who are you, you should say I am a soul.
人们如果问说你是谁，你会说我是灵魂。
Where did you come from? You say I came from Krishna.
然后问说你是哪里来的？你说我是从Krishna 来的。
We want to bring people to the spiritual platform.
我们想要把人帮助人提升到就是灵性的层面上。
So that our soul is without beginning and without end. In Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, "Najayate mriyate va kadachin nayam budva bhavita va bhavita."Nayam budva bhavita vad nabuya ajonityam shaswatoyam purano nahanyate hanyamane sharire. For the soul There is never birth nor death.
马尔吉吟诵这段诗节，他告诉我们，灵性的灵魂它是不生不死的。
Not having once been, does he ever cease to be? He is unborn, eternal, ever existing and primeval. He is not slain, even if the body is slain.
Bhagavad Gita, second chapter, text number 20.
Maharaj 吟诵了整部《博伽梵歌》第二章的第二十节诗。啊，我们现在他说，灵魂任何时候都不生不死，它过去存在，现在存在，将来也存在，永远没有从无到有的过程。它原始、永恒、长存，不经出生就存在。当躯体被杀时，它不被杀。
We encourage devotees to learn slokas from Bhagavad Gita.
我们鼓励奉献者从博伽梵歌中来学习这些诗节。
I remember we used to walk in the morning with Srila Prabhupada, japa walk, and sometimes Prabhupada would talk, and then he would say, "What is that sloka? Who knows that sloka?"
我想起啊，当年Srila Prabhupada在世的时候，那么我们会跟着Srila Prabhupada去做清晨的就是散步就是japa walk。那个时候我们走着走着，然后有时候Srila Prabhupada他讲到什么，他就会想要引用这个诗节啊，《博伽梵歌》中的诗节，然后他就会说哪一节诗啊？谁知道哪一节诗？
We didn't even have the Bhagavad Gita at that time. It hadn't even been printed with the Sanskrit.
当时的我们都还没有《博伽梵歌》呢，我们还没有，这个都还没有梵文诗节，都还没有印出来。
But Prabhupada was asking us, "What is that sloka?"
但是Srila Prabhupada当时就会问哪一节诗，是哪一节诗？
So it's a very nice way to engage the mind.To keep our mind busy in Krishna consciousness by memorizing slokas.
就是 Maharaj 鼓励我们来背诵这个梵文的诗节。他说这个是让我们的心意啊，能够就是从事灵性活动就是控制住我们的心意，一个很好的方法，稳定我们的心的很好的方法。
We're coming up to the day when Lord Krishna spoke the Bhagavad Gita.It's on an Ekadasi day, and on that day, it's customary to recite the whole Bhagavad Gita.
我们每年呢会在就是博伽梵歌的显现日那一天，那我们大家会一起把整部的博伽梵歌就是朗诵读一遍。
So
刚好是 Ekadasi 那一天。
Sometimes we call that the Gita Jayanti.
Gita Jayanti.
But actually, Gita is always there. It's not taking birth. Jayanti means take birth, but the Gita is eternal knowledge.
那 Gita 的意思是永恒的知识。那 Jayanti, 是那个出生的意思。但事实上，不叫梵歌，它是不经出生，它就存在的。但是我们还是这么说，就是它显现的那个世界。
But it's a good day you can advertise and you know, put an advert and encourage people come and chant the Bhagavad Gita, recite the Bhagavad Gita with us. You can attract people, new people, they may be interested.
但是总之博伽梵歌的显现日那天它就是一个很好的时机点，刚好可以让我们去邀请一些新朋友让他们一起来跟我们一起完成这整个这个就是诵读这个博伽梵歌让邀请那些对这个有点兴趣的人让他们能够有机会跟我们一起来学朗读。
Because now there are many Bhagavad Gita, many different editions of Bhagavad Gita here in Taiwan.
Different edition?
Not Vaishnava commentaries.
像博家梵歌其实有很多的版本呢，不是只有我们这个版本。好，像台湾我们也找得到有很多好，就是关于博家梵歌不同的版本的书。
All right, so Lord Krishna is the supreme controller, and he has no beginning, and he has no end.
所以我们从这里这节诗中，我们知道了 Krishna 他是至尊的控制者，他没有开始，也没有结束。
We have no beginning and no end, but we are not the supreme controller.
我们虽然也是不生不死的灵性的灵魂。但是我们却不是那个至尊的控制者，我们并不是。
We are controlled.
我们是被控制的，我们不是控制者。
And you can either be controlled by the material energy or by the spiritual energy.
我们不是被灵性能量控制，要不然就是会被物质能量所控制。
If you're controlled by the material energy,then you're under the control of the three modes, goodness, passion, and ignorance.
如果我们是被物质能量控制的话，那么意味着我们就是被物质自然三种属性所控制，就所谓的善良属性、激情属性还有愚昧属性所控制。
But if we take shelter of the spiritual energy, we're under the control of Krishna's spiritual potency.
可是如果我们是被灵性能量所控制的时候，我们等于是直接受到了 Krishna 的灵性的能量的控制。
This is stated in Bhagavad Gita, Mahatmanastumam Partha Devim Prakritim Ashrita. That the Mahatmas, all of you Mahatmas, great souls, they're under the protection of the divine energyBecause they're fully engaged in devotional service.
在博家梵歌中有这样一节诗，这些 Mahatma, 这些伟大的灵魂他们在我的神性能量的控制之中。
So Lord Krishna is also described by Queen Kunti as being the all-pervasive one. In other words, in his Paramatma feature, he'sEverywhere.
那这边还有讲到，对不起，刚才那个 Mahatma 还有一个，就是说，因为他一直都在为至尊主从事奉爱服务，所以他受到 Krishna 的神性能量的保护。那这边 Maharaj 继续讲到，就是这边 Kunti 王后在荣耀着、赞美着 Krishna， 说您无所不在。那讲到无所不在，我们就知道，这不就是超灵哈？超灵的一个特质吗？这种无所不在的特质。
So Krishna knows about each and every one of us.
Krishna 知道我们每一个生物体的状况。
He's situated in every one of our hearts.
他在我们每一个人的心中。
And he's giving us knowledge, remembrance, or forgetfulness.
我们所有的记忆、知识和遗忘，完全都是来自于 Krishna， 来自超灵。
He knows what we want.
他知道我们想要什么。
If we want to remember him, he will help us.
如果我们想记得 Krishna 也会帮助我们去记得他。
And if we want to forget him, he also allows it.
可是如果我们想要遗忘 Krishna 的话， Krishna 也会帮助我们遗忘他。
Queen Kunti continues, she says about Lord Krishna, she says, in giving your mercy, you are equal to everyone.
接着昆蒂王后又说，至尊主，您对众生一视同仁，你平等施予仁慈。
Right? Now, often people feel that, I don't think God's equal to everyone.He gave everybody but me. Everyone got so much more money than me. I don't have any money. Where is the equality? It's supposed to be equal to everyone? And she's got money and a big car and a big house and I don't have anything? I think he forgot about me.
可是有的人就不相信这个，什么平等对待众生，他说我不相信，如果神真的是平等的，为什么有那么多人，他们都那么有钱，还有那个就是名车豪宅，可是我怎么呢一贫如洗呢？这怎么可能？这个什么叫做平等？一点都不平等。
Well, we have to understand the nature, how Lord Krishna actually is equal to everyone. His position is just like in the court, you have the judge, and the judge will decide how people should be treated. Someone may be punished, someone may be rewarded.
关于啊这个所谓的这个平等性一视同仁的这个概念呢，我们 Maharaj 给我们举了一个例子啊，比方说在这个法院啊，那个法官他会根据每个人值得的对待来判决，比方说这个人该要受到什么样的处罚惩罚，那另外一个人需要受到什么样的奖赏，他一清二楚，他是需要有判断的。
Right. The first case comes when some man was injured in the factory. He was working in the job in the factory and somehow he got injured and he came in the court and the court heard what happened and the judge decided this man should be given compensation. He should be paid some money to compensate him for the injury.
比方说有人他在工厂工作，然后这个员工就来到了法院，他说他要那个就是申请理赔，对不对？因为他在做这个工作的时候在工厂受伤了，所以就是法官他就要判决应该要赔偿这个人。
So the judge decided to give this man 21
然后法官就说好，要赔偿这个人，这工厂要赔偿这个人，因为他受伤了，所以要赔偿他二十万。
And then the next man comes in, and then this man, he was a robber and a thief, and he stabbed people when he was robbing them. He attacked with his knife, and he comes in the court, and the judge hears everything what he does, and the judge sentences him. 10 years in jail.
那还有另外一个强盗，这个强匪就来了，他因为要抢夺人家的财物，他还用刀，知道吗？就是捅了人家一刀，所以法官就说这个人要判决，要关10年。
So the thief, he says to the judge, he said, why you put me in the jail for 10 years? You gave him 21, and you put me in the jail.He said, that's not fair, you should be equal to everyone.
所以这个强盗他就很生气，你知道吗？他说你怎么可以这样，你根本就不是一个公平的公正的法官，你刚才判他可以拿到20万，你竟然说我要判决10年关在牢狱里，他就是很不服气。
But of course it just says everyone gets according to theirActions. Some people deserve to be rewarded. Some people need to be punished.
所以这个没办法，这个种什么因就得什么果啊。根据每个人所作所为，有些人应该受到奖赏，有些人应该受到惩罚。
The judge is equal to everyone. He's not thinking, oh, I like this person, I don't like that person.But he has to hear what have they done and what action needs to be taken.
那关于这个法官，他根本没有什么喜欢哪个人或不喜欢哪个人，其实他就是一个中立的人，他只是根据这个人他所作所为，他理当应该要去给他恰当的判决，恰如其分的给奖赏或者是惩罚，所以情况就是像这样子。
In the same way, the super soul is situated in the heart. And he's like a judge. He also remembers, he knows what we've done. We don't remember, but he remembers.
同样 同理可证就是超灵他位处我们每个人的心中，他见证着我们所做过的每一件事所以他即使我们会忘记，可是超灵他完美的记录着所有的一切，所以他很清楚这个人应该要给他什么恰到好处的这个安排应该奖赏什么处罚什么，他一清二楚，他不会弄错，他是中立的。
So Lord Krishna as a super soul is punishing some people and rewarding other people. When we see people suffering in the material world, we understand this is not by chance. It is reactions due to their past activities.
所以超灵啊，它完全是根据我们自己的所作所为来给我们适当的一个配额无论是好是坏所以当我们看到这个世界上怎么会有这么不公平的事情啊，怎么有人那么好命，有人怎么会那么可怜，可事实上这个可怜之人他必定曾经差点不小心讲出就是他一定是做了什么就是不好的事情，所以他才会得到这样的惩罚。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna also says, Samoham sarvabhuteshu name dveshosti napriya yebajanti tumam bhakta maite teshu chapyaham. Lord Krishna is saying, I envy no one, I'm equal to everyone.
Krishna 他还说，他说我不嫉妒任何人，我平等的对待所有的生物。
But if someone renders service to me, then he is a friend.
但是任何为我做奉爱服务的人，他是我的朋友。
He is in me, and I am in him.
他在我心中，而我也在他心中。
So example is given, just like a woman, women like children, and a little child will, if they will come, all the ladies, you know, they will like so much to see the child, they take pleasure, but they have a special love for their own child.
我们都知道，就是男人、女人啊，特别喜欢小孩，对不对？如果一看到小孩，他 女人一般来讲都特别的喜欢，就很想逗弄那个孩子，哇好可爱哦，都会这样子。可是再怎么样，在小孩子之中，人总是特别的，总是会钟爱他自己的孩子，这是很自然的一种情感。
Is this prejudice?
难道这是一种偏心吗？
No, it's natural that a woman will have a special affection for her own child.
不，这是一种很自然的情感。女人本来就会对自己的孩子就是特别的钟爱，这是很自然的现象。
In the same way, Lord Krishna has a special affection for his devotees.
同样的 ，Krishna 也是对他的奉献者，对他的孩子有特别的的感情和爱。
Because the devotees are so absorbed in serving Krishna, Lord Krishna is attracted by the devotee.
当 Krishna 看到奉献者那么认真的在为他做服务的时候 ，Krishna 会非常受这样的奉献者的吸引。
Lord Krishna reciprocates with the love of his devotees.
Krishna 会去回应奉献者给他的爱。
And he enjoys, you can see with Mother Yashoda, how he is enjoying the love of Mother Yashoda.
Again, how?
Lord Krishna enjoys the love of Mother Yashoda.
Krishna 非常的享受Yashoda 妈妈对他的爱。
Even when Mother Yashoda may even be tying him up, it is a pleasure for Lord Krishna.
即便亚瑟达妈妈她想办法想要用绳子绑住 Krishna， Krishna 还是很开心很享受、啊、这样的逍遥。
Mother Yashoda is not angry with Krishna，
因为亚瑟达妈妈她不是因为生气才要绑住 Krishna 的。
She wants to protect Krishna，
她想要保护 Krishna。
Because she's in the mood of being the mother of Krishna.
因为亚瑟达妈妈她是带着这个母亲的情感哈、哦、来对她的 baby Krishna 的。
The mother always wants to protect their child.
所以母亲始终都是想要保护自己的孩子。
In the same way, Lord Krishna is enjoying that love. This person, they want to protect me. Lord Krishna is enjoying.Getting that service from his devotee.
所以、Krishna 他其实非常享受，他很喜欢、去感受到他的奉献者因为爱他而为他做的所有的那些事情，包括像亚瑟达妈妈想要绑住他，那也是他的奉献者因为爱他所做的一种爱的表现，一种服务，所以 Krishna 非常喜欢。
So sometimes we feel, you know, thatIf there's a God, he's not very kind to me. He doesn't give me any care.
可是有的人会埋怨说，啊、哦，这个神啊，他根本就没有照顾我，他真的不好，他都没有照顾我。
But everything is based on that love. That the more you give love, the more you will get love.
但是我们要了解，所有的一切。都是基于爱为开始的，当我们给越多爱，我们一定会得到越多爱，这是一定的法则。
So Lord Krishna enjoys that loving exchange.
所以 Krishna 他其实非常享受那种跟奉献者之间那种爱的交流，他非常喜欢。
AndWe were saying Lord Krishna is described here that he is eternal time. This time is a very special thing. It is one of the subject matters of the Bhagavad Gita.
这边讲到了这个时间、哦、我们都知道时间呢、啊，它永恒时间是佛家梵歌的、哦、这个五大主题之一，是一个很重要的主题。
Right, there are five topics in the Bhagavad Gita.
对，我在梵歌中有五大主题。
Right, there is God, the Ishvara.
比方说有神 Ishvara.
There are the Jiva, the living entity.
还有 Jiva, 就是个体生物。
And then there is Prakriti, which means the material nature.
还有 Prakriti, 它是物质自然。
And then there is.Kala, Kala, time.
好，再来是 Kala， 哦，这个时间。
And there is karma.
还有最后一个叫 karma.
So all of the things are eternal except for karma.
那这五项刚刚所说的，除了 karma 这个业报之外，其他的都是永恒的。
Time is eternal.
时间是永恒的。
It's going on eternally.
它一直永恒的继续下去，不会中断的。
Even in the spiritual world, there is the influence of time. There's not in the material world. Time decays everything.
这个在这个物质存在中啊、时间呢，它会。带走一切，对不对？它会让所有的一切都经历了这些衰老、消亡这些过程。
You know, these computers don't last very long.
比方说电脑，再怎么样，它也不可能维系很久啊。
And the same, these apartments, we had this temple nicely renovated, and after some years, we'll have to renovate it again.
比方说我们现在中心，Mari说。中心、就是设计啊装饰的那么美，可是可能过了一段时间几年之后，也许说不定我们又必须要再重新装修了。
We see Taipei big buildings, 高楼大厦 everywhere. You know, before they were not there, now they're there. But they won't stay there forever.
对，我们看到那个台北呀、啊，就是这个高耸入云霄的这些摩天大楼，哇，曾几何时，这些都是平地呢，啊，可是现在却都是高楼林立了。所以这个就是永恒时间，知道吗？它的展现啊，它带来了一切，也带走了一切，这些来来去去的，嗯。
So time comes that this it decays everything in this world.
嗯，所以永恒时间，它会带来一切，它也会带走一切。所有的一切随着永恒的时间，它会逐渐的步入衰亡。
Of course, that's good for some people, right? Some people can do good business for that. You know, they, oh, they're getting old. They'll come to get, you know, rejuvenated or something.
Come what?
They'll come to be rejuvenated. To be made young. Yeah. To look young.
对啊，那可能对美容业可能是很好消息，因为还好人都会慢慢的老，对不对？那因为会老，所以啊，那些美容的就是行业就是很兴盛，很赚钱。对他们来讲是好消息。
So in the spiritual world, people don't get old.
可是，在灵性世界，人们并不会变老。
People that have spiritual bodies.
在灵性世界，人们的身体是灵性的身体。
Just like Lord Krishna, when he came in this planet, he had a spiritual body.
就像 Krishna 在这个物质世界就是显现的时候，他就是以他的灵性的身体到来的。
And he was on this planet for more than 100 years.He was on this planet
for more than
100 years.
然后他在我们这个星球上，他停留了一百多年。
But he was still like a young person.
可是尽管是一百多年，你看他永远看起来就是青春年少。
A long black hair.
而且他有茂密的就是长的这个黑发。
His hair didn't go gray.It didn't fall out.
他的头发不会变灰白不会掉头发。对，不会掉发，我说不会掉发。
So that is the nature of the spiritual body.
所以这个灵性的身体多好啊，知道吗？不会什么齿微发秃这些东西都没有问题。
He grew to the point of youth.And then he didn't get any older. He grew up to the point of being a youth.
A youth. 他灵性的身体，他会长到一个程度，知道吗？就是风华正茂那种状态，然后就不会再继续衰老了，不会经历那个状态。
And Rukmini also did not get old.
Rukmini, 她也不会变老。
She was just like the young woman.
哇，真好 ，Rukmini。她是永恒的那种，你知道吗？少女的那种美那种。
Even though they had grandchildren，
即使她已经当奶奶了，奶奶还是那么的美。
Because they had spiritual body，
因为她是灵性的身体，她永不衰老。
They were not under the influence of time。
她永远灵性的身体。永远不会受到永恒时间的影响。
But we are under the control of time.
但是我们却不然，我们一定会受到随着这个永恒时间，我们会逐渐的步入衰老。
In Chinese language, we have some interesting things to say about time.
中文有一些很有意思的话来形容这个时间。
光阴似箭，
光阴似箭，好厉害！
Right, time goes very fast, like the arrow.
对，光阴似箭，像箭一样的飞逝，飞逝。
We came to Taichung more than 20 years ago, 30 years ago.
那么久啊？
嗯。
Maharaj 说，那在三十年前就来过台中。
We started trying to distribute Krishna consciousness.
当时啊，他想办法想要来啊，就是派发这个 Krishna 意识之觉给人们。
Where were you 30 years?
那个时候三十年前你在哪里啊？其他人啊在哪里？
还没出生呢。
出生？他那么年轻吗？
那个时候他是一个老人。三十年以前的时候他是一个老男人。
三十年前他说如果还没出生的话，他可能上辈子说不定是个老男人。那个时候
Time comes and So we have to make good use of time. It's very important.
所以这个时间真的很重要，我们一定要知道怎么去这个面对这个时间怎么善用它。
一寸金难买
寸光阴，
一寸金难买寸光阴。中文老师。
In Chanakya Pandit, in India, they have the same saying. Chanakya Pandit was a great politician in India, and he taught that time is the most valuable thing.
那个 Chanakya Pandit 他印度的这个一个 politician, 一个政治家，他也有这样的说法，真的也很像我们中文讲的啊。
You like that? Make the best use of your time.
意思就是说，既然寸金难买寸光阴，意思就是说，时间是非常珍贵的，我们要好好的善加利用。
So the best use of our time is to use it for the service of Krishna. It gives eternal benefit.
所以善用时间的最好的方法就是。好好的来为 Krishna 做奉爱服务，因为这是能够让我们获得永恒的利益，最高的利益。
If you simply work in the material world, whatever you have in this material world, it's finished with the body.
因为我们在物质上所做的一切，会随着我们躯体的消亡，而就所有的一切就结束了。
Your nice house, your car, your bank balance, you have to leave it all behind.
当我们时日一到必须被迫放下我们的身体的时候，事实上无论我们的银行的存款的数字有多么大然后我们有什么样的豪宅名车又如何，这所有的一切都要放下。
So we have toMake use of our time to do the most valuable thing. The most valuable thing is to take shelter of Krishna, to surrender to Krishna.
所以我们一定要善用时间来做最有意义、最有价值的事情。那么什么是最有价值的事情呢？就是托庇于 Krishna, surrender to Krishna and serve Krishna, 为 Krishna 做服务。
That will give us eternal benefit.
如此，我们就能够得到这种永恒的、最究竟的利益。
It will go in our spiritual bank account.
而所为 Krishna 所做的这些奉爱服务呢，全部都会存在我们的灵性存折里面，灵性的存款簿里面积分。
So that.If you do devotional service, it's eternal benefit.
当我们从事奉爱服务的时候，这个是叫做永恒的利益。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, "Nehabikramana shosti pratyavayona vijate swapam apyasya dharmasya trayate mahatobayat." In this endeavor, there is no loss or diminution.And a little advancement made can save us from the greatest danger. Second chapter, text number 39.
Krishna 在《Bhajan Gita》第二章的第39节诗中讲到， 他说我们就是走在这条道路上啊，他说我们不会就是对我们无论做什么我们都不会失去什么，也不会减少什么，对。
And a little advance,
我们哪怕是在这条道路上前进一点点，都可以使我们得到保护，从而免于最可怕的危险。
So this is the best advice we can get.
所以这个就是我们 Krishna 在国家范克中给我们的教导，让我们了解我们是不会有什么损失的，在这条道路上反而可以让我们 得到这个永恒的利益，永恒的保护。
Get eternal benefit.
所以这个叫永恒的利益。
Sanatana Goswami had a touchstone which could turn things to gold.
Sanatana Goswami 呢，他有一块点金石，他把它丢在垃圾堆。
But this one man, there was this one devotee of Shiva. He heard that Sanatana has got this touchstone. So he came, and he came to see Sanatana, and he was very nice to Sanatana. And he begged, he said, I hear you have a touchstone. Could you give it to me? And Sanatana said, oh, you want that stone? He said, it's over there. I threw it away.
Sanatana Goswami 是这样的，有一个故事曾经有一个 Shiva 的这个跟随者， Shiva 的奉献者，他就听说了 Sanatana Goswami 有一个很有价值的东西，就是那个点金石。那个点金石可以把所有的东西碰触的都会变成金子，所以他就来找 Sanatana Goswami， 他就告诉他说，哦，我听说了你有一个点金石。他说你要这个东西啊，他说给你吧，这个点金石
我已经把它丢掉了，
我这个根本就不要这个东西，我把它丢在一边垃圾堆，你要你去拿吧。
So then the man thought, when he's thrown it away, he thought he must have something more valuable.
可是这个人觉得他后来觉得有点异样，他觉得很怪，怎么有人会把这个东西丢在垃圾堆？那肯定这个人一定有更有价值的东西，他才可能把点金石丢在垃圾堆。
So he came back. He said to Sanatana, "You've got something more valuable, haven't you?" And Sanatana said, "Yeah, I don't want that stone." He said, "You've got something more valuable. Give me that more valuable thing."
所以那个人他本来拿了点金石回去了，对不对？他想一想，不对啊，这个人怎么会把这个东西丢在垃圾堆？肯定他有更好的，他就赶快来找 Sanatana Goswami， 他就说，他说你一定有更有价值的东西，对不对？他说如果有，你赶快给我，你把你最有价值的东西给我吧。
So Sanatana, you wanted the most valuable thing.First, you throw that stone away. You throw it in the Yamuna.
他就说，你真的想要最有价值的东西吗？你如果真的想要，你就把那个烂东西，那个点金石，把它丢掉，丢到Yamuna河去。不要它了。
The man knew if I throw it in the Yamuna, I'll never find it again.
然后
if I put it in the Yamuna.I will never get it again. I will never find that stone.
他就想说，我把它丢到卷木纳河，那我就再也找不到这个点金石了。
But Sanatana said, "I'm not giving you the most valuable thing till you throw that thing away."
他说，可是除非你丢掉，不然我不可能给你更有价值的东西。
So the man threw it away.
所以这个人他就同意了，他真的把点金石给丢了。
And Sanatana said, "Now come sit here, take this."
Sanatana Goswami 跟他说，过来，坐好，开始念诵圣名。
This is the most valuable thing.
他说这是最有价值的，就是圣名。
Don't doubt it.
不要怀疑。
This is the most valuable thing.
这是最有价值的东西。
Okay, any question?
好了，
yes.
还有没有问题？哦，问答有问题。
马老师，我想问一下，就是你刚才在课堂上面有讲说，就是 Krishna 对生物所有生物体都是平等的，就是有因为因果关系有善报有恶报。那我想问，就是在最初，就是最初说，就是 Krishna 创造的时候，那所有的生物体是否有这些善报恶报？是一开始就有的吗？还是说没有啊？然后是因为什么样的关系，所以变成有开始有这些善报恶报？然后有的生物体可以成为奉献者，有的不行。那在另外一个问题是在最后就是毁灭的时候，这些善报恶报是都一笔勾销，还是说？在下一次在创造的时候，又会在那些生物体的身上。
Yeah, well, you have to understand, living entities are eternal.
首先要了解的一件事情，所有的生物体都是永恒的。
So you spoke about the creation at the beginning of the, but we're eternal.Before the creation, there was another creation. You know, this is not the only creation. Just like you wake up in the morning, and you know, you wake up, you're the same person you were before, the same person you were yesterday. You don't change, you know, just because it's a new day.You're not a different person from yesterday. You're the same person you were yesterday, today. You wake up in the morning and, you know, you're the same. You know, you have the same job, you have the same clothes, you have the same duties to do.
那 Maharaji 首先讲一个概念，其实我们是永恒的灵性的灵魂，我们是永恒的。那我们在讲到创造这个概念，事实上我们在创造之前就已经存在了。那我们这个创造之前哦，也有它的创造，对不对？那可是问题是我们是永恒存在的，永恒我们一直都是存在的，所以这个创造这个概念其实它只是一个概念，但并不代表我们真的是被创造了然后才会存在这样子的概念，明白这个意思吗？比方说我们睡一觉起来，事实上睡一觉起来我们还是原本同一个人，我们坐着我们还是同一个人，可能还有同样的一件衣服，还有做同样的工作，同样的个性，我们是原本的同样的那个人，我们并没有说因为睡一觉起来就变成另外一个人了，我们并没有这样子。
So the same way with the annihilation of the universe, our karma will stay with us. The living entities, they may be annihilated, and then when the next creation comes about, then they come with their karma from the past.
因此在毁灭的时候，我们虽然毁灭了，可是我们是永恒的，对不对？所以那个业报它还是会继续期待着，在等待下一次的，知道吗？开始，然后在那些业报又会再展现出来，所以那个是跟着我们，并不是说毁灭了，所以一切就不见了，就像我们睡一觉，好像毁灭，可是不会说醒过来突然就变化了，变成另外一个人了，都没有业报了，明白这个关联性吗？
Yeah.So the karma is going to... What happens is the gross body is annihilated, but the subtle body will remain. And the subtle body carries the karma.
我们要了解所谓毁灭的这个概念指的是我们初造的肉身这个物质躯体。 可是携带着这个业力的是我们的精细的身体，精细的身体携带着我们的业力、哦、灵魂，我们会知道吗？不管是创造毁灭，它携带着、
Yeah, the subtle body that just like when we die, the subtle body doesn't die, right? The subtle body goes with the soul at the time of death. We take our karma with us, with the soul.
就像我们也会面临死亡，我们死亡的时候，就是我们这个物质躯体死亡了，可是精细的身体并不会死亡啊。所以精细的身体携带着我们的业报、哦随着灵魂它继续再去 投生在下一个躯体里头，所以并不会说死亡了那业报就不见了，不是这样。
Karma is not finished, it's there, it's with the subtle body.
所以业报它并不会因为这个物质躯体死亡了就不见了，它会由这个精细的身体继续携带着。
Some good karma and some bad karma.
对，业报包含了好报也有恶报。
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. 网络啊，也有。
啊。
Online, some more questions.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. 啊，我们这边还有一些问题哈。这个 Ananta Vijaya Mataji， 我顶礼啊，这个 Maharaj 的莲花族啊 ，Guru 常说，我们应该执行 Krishna 所需要的任何服务，不管我们喜欢与否。我为 Krishna 执行许多不同种类的服务 Seva， 我享受我所做的一切。这不是感官享乐吗？还有一个问题是，如果药品是由化学物质制成的，可以提供给 Krishna 吗？ OK， Maharaj， 你懂他的听得懂第一个问题吗？他说Guru 常常说我们要去做 Krishna所需要的任何服务，我们应该要去做，无论我们喜欢或不喜欢，我们都要去做，去服务 Krishna、哦、就是 Krishna 所需要的服务我们都要去做。那他说我为 Krishna 做许多不同的服务，然后我很享受这个服务，那这是不是也是感官享乐？
Well,Everything depends on your attitude. Is your attitude to please Krishna?
其实所有的一切都是取决于那个态度，你的心态。如果那个心态是为了取悦 Krishna,
are you doing this action, this service? Are you doing it for the pleasure of Krishna?
你当你做这件服务的时，这项服务的时候。你是为了取悦 Krishna 吗？
Are you just doing it for your own pleasure?
还是为了要去满足你自己，为了让自己高兴而做呢？是哪一种？
If you're doing it for your own pleasure, then it's, yes, it's sense gratification.
如果我们做一个服务是为了自己的享乐的话，那么当然它就是一种感官享乐。
But if you're offering the result to Krishna,
可是如果我们确实把这个结果、是献给 Krishna 的，我们真的是为了取悦 Krishna,
then that's karma yoga, not bhakti yoga.
那么这个叫做活动瑜伽、Mahari 讲的是把我们的活动的结果献给 Krishna, 活动的结果献给 Krishna, 这个叫 karma yoga, 活动瑜伽。那他的另外一个问题 ，you know, if the medicine is made of chemical, can we offer such kind of medicine to Krishna?
Well, can offer it to Vishnu, You can say Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu.
你的药如果 是这样的话，你就不是供奉给 Krishna， 你就念三次 Sri Vishnu， 好 ，Sri Vishnu， Sri Vishnu， 三次。好，好，那我们先来看哦，哈，Premika 是不是 ？Premika Mataji Gurudev。可否告诉我们，当他辞职前往 ISKCON 时，他的父母和亲戚有什么反应？这是什么意思？
是问 Maharaj 吧？
哦哦，是问 Maharaj 吗？
对啊。
OK. He would like to know, when you know, resigned and you decide to join ISKCON.So what's the reaction of your parents?
我没有告诉他们。I'd already left home.
Huh?
I'd already gone out of the home.
那个时候他其实已经离家了，所以他就没有跟父母讲说他加入了 ISKCON。他那时候他已经离家了。
And happened, actually what happened was they did a television program and at the temple they had a program about the devotees, you know, and it was shown at the, and that's when my parents saw that I was a devotee. They were watching television.
有一次啊，这个电视节目知道吗？刚好采访那个可能庙里的活动。然后就拍出了奉献者，然后他爸爸妈妈是在电视上看到他们吓惊呆了，怎么我的孩子在那里变成这样？然后他们打电话给你吗？
没有，
没有，
他们觉得我没办法。
没办法。那我们还有这个 Keshava Priya Mataji 的一个问题哈，礼拜 Guru Maharaj， 礼拜翻译 Mataji， 礼拜所有奉献者，一切荣耀归于 Srila Prabhupada。第一个问题，刚刚接触一个人，他好好奇我在念诵什么，我就叫他念的 Mantra， 可以分享 Srila Prabhupada 的 Japa， 就是音频给他吗？就是 Srila Prabhupada 的念诵给他，可以分享 Srila Prabhupada 的念诵给他吗？第二个问题是，如果不小心冒犯了奉献者，怎么样知道冒犯已经消除了呢？两个问题，第一个问题比较简单，就是说，他是说可不可以把 Srila Prabhupada 的念诵的 chanting 分享给刚刚接触的人，因为他很好奇，对，可以的，没有问题的，可以分享的，那第二个问题是，如果不小心冒犯的奉献者，怎么样才能知道冒犯已经消除了，不见了
？Well, you should think if you've offended the devotee, you should think that the reactions are not over with, and you should want to go to the devotee and get forgiveness.
如果我们冒犯的奉献者。我们应该要这样想，就说觉得冒犯没有结束，并没有结束，我们应该要真诚的去找我们冒犯的那个奉献者，去请求他的原谅。
Yeah, we want to be very careful not to offend the devotees.
我们要非常小心，不要去冒犯奉献者。
Lord Chaitanya had Mother Sachi touched the feet of Advaita Acharya to get free from sinful reactions of offending him.
主舍太亚 Mahaprabhu 甚至于要他的母亲 Sachi Mama 去碰触 Advaita Acharya 的莲花足，因为他冒犯了他的莲花足，他希望能够借此来摆脱他的业报，消除他的冒犯。
Very serious.
所以其实冒犯奉献者是很严重的。
So every day we offer obeisances to the devotees.
所以我们每天都要向奉献念奉献者的顶拜祷文。
And by offering obeisances to them, then we can be relieved of our sinful reactions.
借由向奉献者献上这个顶拜祷文，我们也可以就是消除对奉献者的冒犯，没有去向奉献者道歉也可以消除冒犯。
没有。
Only offer the, you know, obeisances.
We can serve them also by serving the devotees. That's also very good.
用服务奉献者的方法也是很好的。当我们去为奉献者做服务。我们也可以帮助我们去消除这种冒犯。
We may feel that, you know, too embarrassed to go and ask forgiveness.
也许有的奉献者会觉得去跟人家道歉很丢脸，很尴尬，很丢脸。
So you can serve them.
那么就可以去借由去服务我们所冒犯的奉献者来帮助我们。
By serving the devotees, you can be relieved from the sin.By giving service to the devotee,
借由去服务我们所冒犯的奉献者，来帮助我们来解除这些冒犯。
Okay.
Shri Tadrip, Prabhu, 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 最后的故事告诉我们，点金石是不能和圣灵共同拥有的事吗？所以他对Prabhu说 ，You say, you know, the touchstone, and have to throw away, and you know, this way we can have the holy name, the most valuable thing is the holy name. But he said, can we have both at the same time? 不能同时都有两种吗？Holy name and the touchstone.
Yes, you can.
可以
，but you shouldn't be attached.
可以两个都有，但是不要对这个点金石发生执着。
You should be more attached to the holy name.
你要对圣灵更加的依附执着，依附，那不要对那个点金石发生了太多的依附执着。
And if you have the holy name, then you won't care about the touchstone.
可是如果你真的拥有了圣灵，其实你就不会在意点金石了。
You like the person who wants the material, but they also want the spiritual. You have your foot in one boat, and you put another foot in the other boat. You're going to get in trouble.
这个叫做脚踏两条船。如果有人想要又有物质的，然后又要有灵性的。那简直就是一只脚跨在一只船上，另外一只脚就跨在另外一只船上，那一定会有麻烦的嘛。
So you have to be very careful.
所以这个就要小心了。他要用圣点金石来为 Krishna 做服务，就不会脚踏两条船，是不是？海口王。王什么？我不知道。我们想要被灵性能量控制，但有时一不小心又被玛雅控制。我们被两种能量控制的边界在哪里？我们的选择能起到多大的作用？他说 ：“You know, sometimes we want to be controlled.”By spiritual potencies, but sometimes accidentally we are controlled by Maya. So he would like to know, 我们被两种能量控制的边界在哪里？这个要怎么去讲这种意思？我们的选择能起到多大的作用？就是说，So what's the free will, our choice?
Choice is what's for the service of Krishna. And what's for your sense gratification?
我们的选择是说，就是你到底是要来为 Krishna 做服务，还是为感官享乐啊做服务？Maya 做服务。
You have free will, material or spiritual?
我们还是有所谓的自由意志，到底是？就是要偏向物质的这边，还是转向灵性的这边？
Are you going to serve Krishna? Are you going to serve Maya?
你到底要服务 Krishna 还是服务 Maya?
So if you choose Krishna, then you're under the shelter of Krishna.
如果我们服务 Krishna, 我们就会受到 Krishna 的庇护。
But if you choose Maya, then you're okay. You're going away from Krishna. You're coming to the material world.
可是如果选择了 Maya、那么我们就会远离 Krishna， 我们就会奔向物质世界。
So that's your free will.
这就是所谓的自由意志、能够 起到这个作用，我们能够 去善用它来做这个选择的。
You're either a devotee or you're the demon.
我们可以选择到底要做奉献者还是做恶魔。
There's only two natures.
其实也就是只有两种、两种品质。
Divine and demonic.
神圣的品质还有邪恶的品质，你可以选择你自己要去往哪一个方向去走。
正确吗？
这样子可以吗？这个有李宝琦，宝琦说两种点金石和所有财富都可以，和所有财富能量都用来服务主。好，王旭，刚刚那个问题是王旭啊，他所问的问题啊。好，接下来还有一个 Amrita Vilasini Mataji 问的，顶拜灵性导师。我这个问题是替别人问的，奉献者基于关怀与协助另一位奉献者，所以借给了他一大笔钱，但是后来对方就避而不见，删除所有讯息，而且装作若无其事，造成善良的奉献者生活上的经济压力。请问这位 苦主要如何自处？因为这一大笔钱也是他的退休金，他要怎么面对奉献者在怀着信心与关怀呢？ Maharaj, you understand?
Some of it, not all.
Okay.The question is that she, you know, Mataji asked a question for others because a devotee lend money to another devotee due to his concern and you know he want to help the other devotee, but somehow later on the devotee who borrowed the money and he began to avoid herAnd delete all the message, and pretend nothing happened. So, but it causes so much problem for this devotee, because he lent her the money from the money for his retirement. So now he causes his problem. He lose the money. He has trouble to maintain his living. But this devotee who borrowed the money pretend nothing happened.And he didn't want to return the money. So how can he have?
I just had that situation in Taipei. I was in Taipei this year. Yeah, you're either Mataji Lila Tasho. Oh, Ben Lai said, Lingwa Iga Mataji Lila Tobi Tasho, why you're Tobi? Tasoli Hot. Lingwa Iga Mataji Lila Goswa.这个托币的人他借了150万没有还给一分钱他借了150万给占了吧他说他借了一百 他逃避你，你应该注意啊。
所以这样知道吗？哈，就是可能是台北那边发生的同学们讲的一些问题，那我们就低调一点，因为这个事情好像有点。
OK。
好，这就。
马哈拉，我有
这
个问题。
但是马哈拉他的问题是说，怎么面对奉献者在怀着信心与关怀，怎么帮助他呢？他很难过，他就失去了信心了。他觉得奉献者怎么会是这样做人处事的呢
？Well, you're too stupid with your money and give the money away like that. That was foolish.
啊，没错。
They were foolish to give their money away.
哦。我借钱给别人。
Don't think because someone's a devotee they won't cheat you. You know, the people can be cheating. Devotees also cheat.
所以我们不要当傻奉献者。奉献者还是有可能傻傻的被骗，知道吗？并不是说奉献者就一定都没有任何问题呀、啊。所以我们还是要审慎的明辨做判断。不是说所有的人只要是奉献者都可以借钱给他。
有两个男人，他们都是奉献者，他们一起合作做生意，一个人骗别的人，那个人我们的钱都在哪里，别人说都没有，都忘了我们赔。
对，他就骗他说我们的就是两个合作嘛，对不对？然后后来他就另外一个就说钱，我们的钱都没有了，对不对？我们合作的资金都没有了。
所以那个人说不能依附，你应该你是奉献者，应该不依附钱。
没有什么。
Don't be attached.
他这个骗了人家的钱的人还说你是奉献者，你不要那么执着那个钱呐、啊。骗人家钱的人还叫人家不要执着。这个太扯了。所以大家要小心啊，不是说奉献者就是怎么样都没问题，还是要小心啊。啊，还有 Rasika 有问题，好，什么问题啦？
好了，去那个想用的。就是我想请问马哈拉一个问题，就是刚才我们说了哈，永恒的时间它就是超灵控制一切，包括我们的快乐和痛苦都是超灵在控制的。那永恒时间呢，控制的所有的一切，也是包括我们的命运都包括在内。但是如果我们有了Krishna 的知识，我们在修习奉爱，那在修习的时候不能改变命运吗？还是说这个所谓的永恒的时间已经包括了一切，已经安排好一切，这也包括了我们有在修习奉爱瑜伽吗？
你听得懂他的意思吗？Maharaj, Rasika's understanding is that she thought you talk about eternal time, kala, control everything, witness everything. So she thought, so maybe everything is already destined. Yeah, is it true? But then does it mean that if we cannot change our destiny? So she would like to know.So since, you know, the eternal time control everything, including all our karma, so our karma is already destined.
But karma is not eternal.
但是你要了解一件事情，我们说有业报不是永恒的，对不对？对，不是永恒的。
So what is done can be undone.
所以已经做了的事情，其实是有可能被就是修复的，就是做了的事情，可是你是可以就是把它抹，就是说可以，你可以把它就是 恢复，恢复。
So your destiny can be changed.
所以命运是可以改变的。借由这个，知道吗？这个灵性的练习是可以改变命运的。好，本来是已经做了不好的事情或者怎么样，但是可以改变。
Just like you may cut your finger, a little cut in the finger, and actually before you, if you had not been a devotee, you were meant to be stabbed to death. But because you've taken up devotional service, your karma was reduced to a little cut in the finger.
他说，比方说，我们可能我们的指头，对不对？就是去切到这个指头。那我们知道，有些时候，本来我们要经历的不是只有切到这个指头，是更可怕的那个业力。可是由于我们真的是做了奉爱服务，或许呢，就让这么一点点小小的这个伤害，他就拿走了我们最可怕的危险。
这个意思是说，只是修补而已嘛，而不是改变嘛，改变我们的命运。
可以改变。
对。
可以改变。可以改变，并不代表说我们 ，Maharaj， we still have to suffer from our karma， but we can change it。But before we or completely change it， we still have to suffer from that。So should you like to know, does it mean that we can change our life completely, or just we still have to shoulder some, you know, responsibility for our past misdeeds?
No, you can be freed from all your past misdeeds.
Completely free.
Yeah.
But you say, you know, still some token, right? Yeah. Originally we have to suffer much more.
Yeah.
Yeah.But not just a little. So she's saying, how come still a little?
Well,
you have to suffer.
You have to take up devotional service fully. You have to take up the full surrender. As you surrender unto me, I reward you accordingly. Krishna said, I will protect you.
对 ，Maharaj 说这个关键是在于什么？就是我们说我们在练习，对不对？可以改变，但是问题是我们要全然的臣服，到我们真正是叫做在做奉爱服务的那种状态，我们可以全然的让自己从这个可怕的业报中解脱出来。可是在那之前，不是会有一点过程？我们又不是立刻变成纯粹奉献者，所以那么一点点的展示的业报，那是很自然的嘛，是不是？
这不是问题，是应该算是我的一点见解哈。就是刚才马哈拉说那个奖赏跟惩罚哈，所以真正的平等应该是建立在不同工不同酬，这才是真正的平等的意思。
不同工不同酬，
对，
什么意思？
就是每个人的薪水不是都一样啊，是不同工不同酬嘛，这才是平等，不是说每个人的薪水都是一样嘛。
哦，对，因为这个是要在业报法则的，对，根据业报法则才是平等的啊。如果没有这个业报法则，每个人都一样，都一样的东西，那反而是不平等了。对，没有错，他就是讲这样子。Yeah, because you say every you give the example about to explain.The karma, we have to understand. So actually, karma is real equality, because equal, because everybody got what she deserved. So this is real.
Yeah.
This is equal. This is equal.
Yeah.
Fair. This is fair. Yeah.
Yeah.
对，这是真正的公平的待遇是这样，因为每个人根据他的状况，那先到这里好吗？好，先到这里。那现在因为时间比较晚，但是我们还是要供灯。那哦，好，那个是那个今天是 Rasika 做的，是不是 ？Rasika 做的甜哦哦，那个是 Sashimai Mataji 做的，哇。